If you look in the dictionary, the standard definition of to pay dividends is to receive benefits, to receive good things, something people want. But in fact, that's a mistake in a financial context. My co-author, David Solomon at USC, and I document what we call the free dividend fallacy in our new research. Many investors view dividends as an independent source of income. The same way you would view, say, the payments from a bond. So you buy a bond, because you know it'll give you a little bit more money when it pays out, say, a year later when the bond comes to maturity. So the problem is that when you're thinking about a dividend on a stock, the price of a stock drops by the amount of the dividend when the dividend gets paid. So if you have a stock that's worth $10 and it pays a dollar worth of dividend, the price goes to $9 and you've got a dollar worth of dividend. So unlike the bond where if it paid a certain coupon payment, you end up with more money, when you receive a dividend, you have the exact same amount of money, just labeled slightly differently. People tend to miss the price drop because lots of other things happen when dividends get paid. So it's true that on average, the price drops by the amount of the dividend, but markets move, new information comes out, the price fluctuates around. So the actual correlation between the price change and the dividend gets pretty noisy pretty quickly. In our paper, what we show is that if you're an investor and you're holding a stock because you want the cash payout, you're less likely to sell it. Also, you're less sensitive to price changes for dividend-paying stocks. Investors seem to desire receiving this kind of dividend cash payout more or less based on kind of market conditions, how valuable they seem. So the closest analog to this probably is a bond payout. So what we show is when the interest rates are low, the demand for receiving dividends is significantly higher. Also, when the market has been performing poorly, demand is higher. And when the dividend has been more stable or increasing, demand is higher. Now, what's interesting here is we show that this impacts the total market return surrounding dividends. And also ends up impacting valuations. And so what this means is if just individual investors kind of were randomly exhibiting this fallacy and not impacting the market, well, maybe it would have a bit of a tax impact or there'd be some direct trading costs. But what we show is that in times of high dividend demand, holding these dividend-paying stocks yields significantly lower expected returns. So this moves this fallacy from being something that's kind of smaller on the margin to investors are leaving significant amounts of money on the table. We show roughly the size of the equity premium over the next year when they're buying dividend-paying stocks, when everybody else seems to be wanting to receive these dividends and hold these dividend-paying stocks.